songs off his album. Gee, they were good. I tell you, really. Get into those. Have you got that album?
No, I got the single. Have I don't think the album's out yet.
Is that? Yes,
I'll be out by now, yeah.
Yes.
Wasn't out 6 weeks ago.
Oh, wasn't it? Oh, well, I might borrow it off you when you get it and we can tape that. So, and my friend bought...
You had a haircut.
No.
You have had a haircut and you didn't ask me. Remember you got in trouble last time?
I didn't ask you. I don't need to ask you. My mother goes, she reckons it looked like a preschooler's haircut.
Does now.
Oh, stop it. Actually, this looks funny on there. This is a really nice blue. It comes up different on the telly.
Yeah.
Oh, never mind. Guess what?
What?
My friend bought me, you know that, I should go and get it. It's downstairs. That song off the Nescafe ad. You know that one, the French one? You sing it. You sang it the other week. Yeah, that's it. I can hear somebody singing it upstairs. You know?
Oh, it's on the new Sue Clacker album too. That's French.
Clacker. You will get into so much trouble for saying that.
Why?
I wouldn't say it if
she's
I was.
She's a good friend of mine.
She is too. I know her, yeah. She's a lovely lady. All right, Agro, what's the first cartoon?
I went to her sports races at her school.
What do you mean?
She was in the 400 metres and I was going to go be a clacker, go be a clacker, go be a clacker. And she won.
You're a moron. You are.
You're the one talking to a piece of carpet and you're calling me a moron?
Sorry. I didn't mean to.
Oh, it started early. You're not going to get through 6, sure?
I'm not going to get through 6. I'm sorry, Wayne. Let's have a look at... Have you seen this cartoon, this Grave Dale High? Is it any good?
It's not bad.
It's okay. Is it? It's okay. You know what I think is a good one?
What?
Jetson's one, that's it.
Oh, please,
I'm not
going to
make
cartoon.
It today.
Hey, the first host. Hitting some wall.
With thanks to Coca-Cola.
What do you do? You sound like a crow.
Do I?
Yeah.
Just call me Graham.
No. So, Agro, what...
Hey, we didn't say good day to Wally yet.
Okay. Good morning, Wally. Wally.
No. You turn around and you go, good morning, Wally.
Good morning, Wally.
Wally, bend over.
Wally.
What's that?
And when that first State of Origin game was played here at Lang Park in July 1980...
Okay, can we just look? Tell you what music I do on it. What's that nice music that we dance to?
Wait till they say, here comes the king.
And they call the king.
King. Listen.
Wally Lewis actually takes full control of his team.
Who takes full control of his team?
Players know where he wants to go.
Love his mate, Agro.
Almost countdown.
Listen to it. Is it loud?
Here comes the king.
Thank you. Can we have that other music that we like? What's the really groovy? Hang on.
I don't know.
Hit it! Who's on audio today? Is it Michael?
Laurie. Good
what?
Luck. Good luck.
Laurie? Well, okay, Loz. Well, I think it's the green button, okay? It's the green button you push. That means go.
Let's try this one. Oh.
No, the orange. Try the orange one. You know, it's got the little smiley face on it.
That one.
No.
Pardon me.
The purple button upstairs. Try that one.
No.
Laurie, where's our music? You know, the... I know you're not that hip, but you could sort of, you know, try this morning. Go on, put yourself out. Come on. Have you got it there?
I'll get the moo and the duck goes quack.
No! No, Laurie, no! For those of you just tuning in, Laurie, that audio man upstairs.
Grab Dale High.
Oh.
Yes, it's me, Lawyer Zainforest, waiting here in McDonald's. It's a beautiful afternoon, and as you can see, I've got lots of vacant seats around me. 10 vacancies exact, because we're giving you the chance for you and 9 of your friends to go in a great party here at McDonald's. And it's all thanks to the party. Yes, the great new group who've got a new single out called That's Why. We've got a wonderful first prize, as I said, of you and 9 of your friends having a party, as well as a great party pack. Now in the party pack, you get the 7-inch single, you get the 12-inch single, you also get a great t-shirt, as well as a poster. We've also got 5 consolation prizes of party packs. Now, let's have a look at their new single, That's Why, and you'll see That's Why you'll have a great party. There we are. Very easy to enter. Right into the party competition. Give you box 787, Brisbane, Queensland 4001, and you could be sitting here having a great party. Where are those kids? They're late.
I've never heard of that band.
Hey?
I've never heard of that band.
I've never heard of that band,
the
too.
The party.
The party, and you can win that party, so get your entries in. See you after Great Bell High.
What's your diet?
Wow, nearly late to ask my questions on the street. I'm Adrian from Agro's Carlin Connection, your ace reporter. Radically excellent, ear to the ground. In fact, my ear is so close to the ground, I could be run over by a bat. Pretty radical, eh? Okay, let's go and ask some questions. Excuse me, girls. I'm Adrian from Agro's... Oh, you're not a girl. Sorry. I'm from Agro's Carlin Connection. You're wearing a singlet. Can I ask you a really personal question? You're wearing a singlet?
Yep.
Yep. Do you think men should wear singlets?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So they're not all smelly?
Yeah.
Yeah, basically. Do you think men should wear singlets?
Yes.
Yeah?
You're okay. Sweaty,
so. Oh, yeah, yeah, but I've got a singlet on, see? Oh, no. Show my belly button then. Come on. Excuse me. Excuse me, no, listen. I'm Adrian from Agro's Cardo Connection. Are you wearing a singlet?
Uh-huh.
A singlet, you know.
No.
Undergarments. You're wearing a singlet? You're not? Do you think men should wear singlets? You know, keep the smelly away. Yeah? Yeah, okay, thank you.
No worries.
Thanks very much. Excuse me. I'm Adrian from Agro's Cardo Connection.
Hi.
Do you think men should wear singlets underneath their shirts, you know?
No.
Oh, don't you? Do you think I get a bit smelly?
Yeah, it gets too hot. It's too hot for
you think
them.
So?
Yeah.
You think you rather men who don't wear singlets?
Doesn't worry me.
Doesn't worry you? You're not really, really radically, excellently upset by it?
No.
Oh, okay. Thanks very much.
Okay.
I'm Adrian from Agro's Carlin Connection. You're wearing a singlet there, I can see, can't you? Aren't you? Yes.
That's right.
Do you think all men should wear singlets underneath their shirts?
Of course they should.
They should, shouldn't they? Yes. Otherwise you get a bit smelly, don't you think?
Well, you're not too bad, mate.
How can you tell I wasn't wearing a singlet? I think that's really rude and impersonal. This is Adrian on the street for Agro's Carlin Connection. Check you later.
Agro, hello. It was nice and close there. First thing in the morning, not a good thing, is it, folks? All right, I've got this for you.
Well, you haven't got a skin problem this week, have you?
I've got the... Oh, I'm sorry, it's the other arm. Oh, yes, I forgot about that. I've got this for you. Go Crows.
Oh, and Adelaide.
Adelaide, mate. Adelaide, go Crows.
Adelaide.
Right, from 5AA. So we're going to stick that on the fridge with our other things.
That
like.
Should alienate just about everyone in Victoria?
No. Well, we can get ones from like St Kilda and Hawthorne and Melbourne and all.
Molly Meldrum goes for St Kilda.
Does he? Yep. I like Carlton the best and Melbourne.
Why, who's in Carlton?
Oh, I don't know. I just like the navy blue. It looks awfully smart on the field, doesn't it, Mum? See ya for the Flintstones.
What do we do now, Rock?
Now it's time for wildlife, what used to be on Wombat until it got the fleek with Ranger Tim.
That's right.
And look, it's a cucubra.
Agro, look, before we talk about cucubras...
Is that a cucubra?
It is. It's a kookaburra. Kookaburra, say it properly.
Kookaburra.
Kookaburra. Look, before we get into the business side of things, have a look at this. I need a really tight close-up of this. All right. Now, you haven't seen this.
Okay, let me look.
Have a look at this. Now let's go have a look. Hero. That's you and I. Now look at the bottom. Look at the autograph on the bottom. Coming in now. Can you see that?
Oh, that's not Wally.
Look at that. That is. That is two Ranger Tim best wishes. Best wishes. Wally Lewis. What do you think of that?
You walked up to Wally Lewis and asked for his autograph?
I'll tell you what I did. I knew Wally was around. I knew Wally was in studio. And Ranger Stace was in studio, and I said, Stace, you're not leaving that building until you get Wally's autograph.
Yeah, but you got Wally's autograph?
I did. Look, I have. It says it there, to Ranger Tim, best wishes, Wally Lewis.
Why didn't you get to Agro, my friend Agro or something?
Well, I couldn't ask for 2 autographs. I just wanted him to say best wishes to me. No, it's all right. Agro, it's all right. I'll tell you what. No, look, come back. Look, what I might do What we might do.
Might.
No, you all right, well, okay, okay.
You should have been in the army. You know why you should have been in the army?
Why?
Gunner. You could have been a gunner. I was gonna do this, and I was gonna do that. You should have been in the army.
All right, okay, let's shake it. We'll shake hands on this.
No.
No, look, Agro, if I say I will get you Wally's autograph, I'll get you Wally's autograph, all right. What would you like it to say? Would you like it to say something like, to Agro, my dearest pal, Wally?
No, no, to Agro, thanks for all the footballing tips.
You think he'll write that?
Probably.
Okay.
Thanks for all the footballing tips and your help in making win a lot of games.
Oh, all right. Well, that's a lot for him to write. We can ask him.
No, well...
Well, look, what I'd like to do, I really want to go and put it up here. I really would like to put it up here near the King's portrait over here, all right?
But it's got your photo on it.
But that's all right. You're on it too.
Well, that was an award-winning shot. That one came from there up to the big one. Yes! The ladies are out again this year!
Yes. Look, talking about award-winning camera shots, let's have
a look
at that.
I'd like to thank my mother.
No. Look, the awards haven't been given out. All right, okay.
Practice away. We've got to hurry. We didn't even get to Kookoobra.
No, we didn't.
Can we leave him till tomorrow?
We can do that. I'll bring him back.
What's his name?
Well, Ben. Benjamin the Kookoobra. Kookaburra. You've got me saying Kookoobra. It's a blue-winged Kookaburra.
Kookoobra.
It's a Kookaburra and it's called
Ben. And thanks for getting Wally's autograph for your own self.
Oh, Agro, don't help. No, don't hate me. Look, I'll try my best to see if I can get Wally's autograph. Don't be sad. Let's have a look at the Flintstones.
Saw Wally, you didn't even mention it.
No, look, I'll tell you.
No, you will not talk.
If everybody had a vote across the USA, then everybody be served like California.
Having a bit of a rest. I've got my Donut King donut and my can of Stun Kiss from Schweppes. Yes, so we're giving you the chance to see the Iron Man of your choice. The wonderful Donut King Schweppes Iron Man competition. Yes, you can choose from four events. That's North Bondi in November, or you might choose Manly this December. You might want to go to Portsea next January, or you might want to go all the way to Queensland next February to Coolum. The choice is yours. We'll take you and a family member, fly you there from anywhere in Australia with East West, and you'll stay 5 nights at the event of your choice. Wonderful competition. All you have to do to enter is write your name, age, and address on the back of an envelope. Send it in. Donut King Schweppes Iron Man competition. GPO Box 787, Brisbane, Queensland, 4001. You could be soaking up the sun like Iron Man Roy. I don't know how I'm doing, really. One of those things.
USA. Really, I like that music. And by the way, that Donut King competition, looky. Oh, the ones with the jam in the middle. And these are really yummy. Which one have you got, Agro? Excuse me? What are you looking at?
Because Ranger Tim met Wally Lewis and he didn't get a ride up.
Oh.
Didn't write his name.
Come here, turn around.
You went to Movie World, you got Wally Lewis.
Turn around. Here, I'll give you a cuddle.
Ah, I might be short-sighted, I'm not desperate.
We'll have a look at the Flintstones. Come on, I'll give you a cuddle. We'll meet Wally.
Hunter Trading.
Welcome back to Agro's Cartoon Connection. We have a very special person with us this morning. Agro, do you know Stephanie?
I know she's a bit potty.
No, well, she is a little bit potty, but Stephanie is from the Queensland Potters Association.
Oh, hello, Stephanie.
Hello, Agro. How are you?
Very well.
Yeah.
Well, this is all some of your work?
Oh, yeah, it is.
Well, it's not mine, but it's some of the kids' work.
All right.
Oh, but do you teach them?
Yes.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's just have a look. They've made all these little things here. Now, it's not really that hard, is it? I mean, like, you can just let your mind go wild, can't you?
That's exactly the best way to be. Let your mind go wild with this.
Oh, I'd hate to see Ann-Maree with some dough.
Thank you very much.
Not dough. What's it made out of?
Clay. And I've got some here, so you can actually
right.
have a fiddle
now,
around.
Oh, can I have some?
Yeah.
I'm going to call that Cassius.
Oh, okay. All right. I was telling you before, I did this at school.
You got to need it.
You got to really want it. You got to need the dough.
Not the dough.
What, the clay?
Clay.
Oh, I need the... All right, well, that's your blob there, okay?
Hello, Cassius.
Okay, you just...
That's Cassius Clay.
Put your little fingers on there and...
Oh, that's it. Stick them to it. That'll be good. I'll stay here for half an hour then.
Be careful it doesn't dry on you. You'll be there for more than half an hour.
Oh, really? We might just put your little hand down.
Then you'll be charged with kiln.
Kiln. Oh, stop it. Look, Agro, just put your little handprint in there.
No, but did you see that, like, in Ghost, he goes, oh, my love.
Excuse me, that's enough.
My darling.
All right, yes.
Yes, but you haven't got a thrower here today. That was a...
That's on the wheel. That thing that makes you
What's
very
it called?
Giddy.
A thrower?
Yes, that's the person who does it, is a thrower.
A thrower.
And it's a wheel that you use.
And
it
goes... And you've got to get all the water.
Mm, but these are all hand-built just by using plastic.
So if I was interested in doing something like this, I would just bring up like my state's potting association.
Right. And they'll put you on to some teachers. Now, what they've done here, it's just normal clay, and they've made something now. What do you have
But how
to
do they get it shiny? What's the story?
Yeah.
Oh, this is a glaze on top of this. This is one that's sort of midway.
Midway.
And that's made and fired once, so it's a bit... You can hear him, he's fired.
Yep.
And then you put him in the kiln again with some glaze on it and they go all shiny.
Guess what?
Colours.
All right.
I reckon our producer's Potter. He was fired, wasn't he?
Well, Stephanie, thank you for coming in and just having a chat. Now, you'll be back on Monday.
Have you been told?
We'll see you after this. Stop it. Say goodbye.
The Haunted.
The power of the mind, boys and girls. Power of the mind. Concentration. Do you know we only use about 2% of our brains? I use about 5% of mine. I'm above intelligence cloud, boys and girls, but there are some people on this earth who are so marvellous with their brains that they can bend spoons, you heard that, boys and girls? Just pure concentration can bend a spoon. I have this guy in America who rubs spoons all day and he gets them to bend. I did that last night, boys and girls. I sat on this one. Look at that. Took me about 3 seconds to get that one like that. But this is not concentration, boys and girls. It's just sitting in the wrong spot. I'm talking about the power of the mind. Boys and girls, this is the battered slipper of levitation, boys and girls, and you're going to see something absolutely marvelous here today. Something this slipper will move. After this little story, you will believe a slipper can fly. Right, I'm going to go prove this to someone, boys and girls. Excuse me, how are you? How are you? Do you believe a slipper can fly? 2 minutes of your time. 2 minutes of your time, you got a leather tie. Look as though you're a bit of all right.
I'm in a hurry.
You're not in a hurry. Are you in too much of a hurry to see the slipper of levitation? All right, you missed the slipper of levitation. Don't tell me that's the saddest thing I've ever seen, boys and girls. He missed out on the wonderful phenomenon of the slipper of levitation. Slipper of levitation.
Yeah?
You will believe a slipper can fly. When you look at that orange, what do you see?
An orange?
No, you're supposed to use thought, concentration. That's just not an orange. You think when Captain Cook sailed past Australia, he just looked over and said, oh, there's another bit of sandy old island, I'll pass right by that one. That's not an orange, that could be anything you want.
Okay.
All right?
Yes, all right.
All right, you believe me?
Yeah, I do.
And this is a slipper of levitation.
Okay.
You are... Concentration of my mind, this slipper is going to move of its own velocity, ferocity of kinetic energy.
Okay.
All right?
All right.
The battered slipper of levitation. I'm now going to concentrate so hard that slipper is going to move of its own accord. All right?
All right.
I'm concentrating. There it is. Look, can you see that?
That's brilliant. That's fantastic.
There you go. Look at that. That is pure thought transfer. Now when you look at that orange, what do you see?
Still an orange, sorry. I'm sorry.
Some people just don't believe, boys and girls.
He is an absolute worry, that clown.
Yeah, I saw a piece of fishing line attached to that slip.
So did I. Look very carefully, kids. Look very carefully. We'll see you after the new Yogi Bear show.
Oh, what's this like?
We're in the middle of Baja Bandit territory, and I expect any moment to come across a Baja Bandit. What did I tell you? Never doubt Loy Rainforest. Carefully now, Loy, you don't want him to bite you. Oh, yes. You've got to be very quiet when you're around the Baja Bandit, and don't you excite them because they could bite you. Yes, This is a turbo barger bandit. And I'm only joking, it won't hurt you at all. In fact, it'll give you lots of fun because it's a remote control, radio control car. And it's one of the wonderful prizes we've got in the Kids Biz Super Surprise Pack competition. You can win a great selection of prizes. We've got two huge packs full of prizes. Have a look at these. If I may cast an eye for you, I might bring your attention to the Rumblestone. I might point out the Rad Soaker. I might say to you, look at that lovely Susie snapshot. Look at that marvellous water baby, or baby face. And there you go. So, if you'd like to win these fabulous prizes, write into the cartoon selection. Kids Biz Surprise Pack Competition, GPO Box 787, Brisbane, Queensland, 4001. You've got to be in it to win it. Oh, look at that! Soldier ants! Ha-ha!
Soldier ants! Ha-ha! Listen, Laurie, our audio man will try one more time. Quieten the floor, please. One more time, Loz, for that music. You know the music, Agro, where we get the tambourine out?
Like from the Guardian Angel School of Wynnum.
Yeah, like they would like it. Maybe they'd like it. Can we have it, Loz? Have you got up there? Not the happy hoedown. Oh, Laurie, don't. Come on, it's not that hard. Oh, look, they're all doing this. What does that mean?
It means that your act isn't very good.
Well,
I've seen it in discos all over Australia.
We'll have a look at the new Yogi Bear show. Hold on, have a chat to him. And good morning to Melissa Campilos and Alicia Knight. And they both live in Coolaroo, which is in
Victoria.
Down in
Coolaroo.
Victoria. And look at that.
Good name for a homestead, isn't it? Coolaroo.
Coolaroo. Uluru, yeah.
Well, I love it.
Look, well, yes. Look, here we go. We've got a book for you. There we go.
Bag.
A badge. Look.
Is that a book? Is that a book about motels?
No, it's about flags. It's all about flags. Oh, stop it. And a pencil case for Agro with all these pencils in it. Check that one out.
Oh, what a... Look at that. Look.
And...
Oh, that is so good. That is so good.
A little writing book for you. There's a writing book.
Thank you. Thank you. So I can write back.
And I've done these. Now, these are like little stencil things. You might have done this with a coin and a 20-cent piece. You know how you rub it and it comes... Can you see that?
Oh, it looks like a stencil of an Ann-Maree doll.
Oh, stop it, all right? So there you go. Now the letter.
But that one's been distorted. That one's got hips.
Oh, Agro, look. Excuse me.
Is someone talking?
Excuse me.
Oh! Yeah, hello.
That. Enough.
Okay.
All right. Otherwise, you know what happens when you get naughty, don't you?
Yes, the ratings go up.
What happens when you misbehave?
The ratings go through the roof.
What else happens when you misbehave?
The show gets the flick and Disney takes over.
No, what else happens when you're naughty?
I don't know what.
You get a smack.
Oh, well, there's no need to be so mad about things. You get so mad, don't you?
Agro, that's enough, okay? Don't push me. Just don't push me. All right?
Okay.
Today?
Okay. All right.
Very, very nice to me today.
Okay.
All right. No cheeky stuff or anything.
No.
All right, here we go. Look, they've done you a letter here. All right, there you go. And it's got all this.
Agro's colouring book. Yes, there's me down there.
Yeah, and there's Agro there.
An angel.
And there's a...
Look! We're the answer to every question's right before your very eyes. And here's our captain of the clues. Here's Mike Mead.
All right. Now look, Agro. The girls have also sent a quick letter. We'll just have to quickly read this. My name is Melissa. I'm writing this with my friend Alicia. We are your number one fans. And we love the Turtles. And we cried when Ann-Maree smacked you that day. Well, I'm sorry, but he was very, very naughty. And he did deserve it.
That's capital punishment.
It is not. It's just, you know, I feel sorry for all the little...
What are you, is it a sport?
Yeah, well...
Agro smacking?
Yes, a brand new sport. All right, lots of love from Melissa Campilos and Alicia Knight, that's what I'm trying to say, and they've sent us all these other little...
But what do they win?
And things, heaps of things. Check this out, quickly. Here we go, we've got those rubber things there, we've got vouchers from donuts.
Plaster frog.
Excuse me, plaster fun house, thank you
a
very
donut.
Much.
A donut.
Lacy things, chalky frogs, we've
Mind
got
you,
socks
the mail's
from
a bit slow.
We've got everything.
The Dowie could be a bit stale.
That's enough.
Yogi bear.
Hey, look, Agro, where are you?
Here I am.
Come here.
Who
look.
Brought that back for you?
Pardon? Sophie from Saturday Dizzy, and look, she put on the back my name. might be a bit crooked, so you can wear my hat today.
Thank you very much.
Look at you.
Now can I have my Saturday time slot back? Here's the Jacksons.
Stop it!
Bears in the...
Here's the...
Cartoon.
Jetsons. And now you three take care of yourself.
The Pizza Hut at Newmarket doing putting a thin and crispy in the oven.
Excuse me, my friend saw him at the 7-Eleven down at Annerley the other day. True, true. Kid you not. Have a great weekend. By the way, today and tomorrow, last 2 days of the Melbourne show, so get in quick here, Channel 7, Agro and Ann-Maree show bags. All right, have a fantastic day, whatever you're up to on the weekend.
Have a fantastic day.
Laurie, can we have a bit more to the floor, please? Thank you.
Oh, I don't feel like singing.
Bye.
I feel like getting some Mickey.
Cartoon Connect.
Cartoon Connection. We're going to have a connection. It's time for Cartoon Connection.
Good morning, Lawrence.
Hello, Agro. How are you?
Oh, pretty good. I just had some photos done for Women's Day.
I know. All right, listen, we'll do it quickly. Good morning, Wally. Done it before you even thought about it.
Oh, thank you.
See,
hey, does Tim's photo have to be up there?
No, take it down.
Yeah, because he didn't get an autograph for me.
All right.
So why should Ranger Tim be up there?
Well, listen, how about we just put
him on the side of the fridge so hardly anyone sees it.
No.
Put on the inside door of the fridge.
Oh, Agra, that's being mean.
Yeah, I know, that's my whole act.
Well, we'll cover up the...
yeah, in front of the grapefruit juice, the pretend one.
There you go.
Gee, they did a good... Open that door again.
And
they
tonight,
did a great job on that painting, didn't they? Look at that.
They did. They certainly did.
It's really neat. What does he do? Take a mouthful and go...
Agro, then.
Who is that guy?
Look, actually, we've got to check
does
what
he take
we
a mouthful
have.
And go...
Look, we've got...
I might get my car done.
Big dog food. How much dog food have we got? We've got oysters, fish, butter, doggy dessert, food, cat food.
Yeah, but it's all pretend, doesn't matter.
We don't have a cat. Oh, we do
it's
have
It's pretend,
cat.
Like romper room, you know?
It is
Here's
too.
Me always thinking there was a mirror in that thing.
Well, you know, that's like...
I can
like,
see to you too. Never said Agro.
Never said Ann-Maree.
No.
My friend went on that, I told
and
you.
Why did Mr. DB talk like that?
No, he said, wah, like that. He used to speak. He did. He used to go, And then they'd drive around in their cardboard cars. Well, I mean, how silly was that? Turning around.
Yeah, they weren't even serviced.
Exactly.
That's dangerous.
Exactly. And
you could lose footing on a corner and then you might roll in your orange crate.
Exactly. And then they had those hobby horses.
Well, don't get up on your soapbox, will you?
No, but I did. I used to have one of those hobby horses.
Hey, let's save some time for later in the show, eh?
Oh, okay.
Birkdale High. We don't need another hero.
No, we've already got Wally Lewis, and that's even a handful of the best of times.
Oh, yeah, that's what you say now, but when you see him in movie world, you run up and go, oh, Wally, can
I just
hello, Wally, hello, Jackie, how's the kids? Oh, how's Lincoln? Oh, yeah, how's Mitchell?
Mitchell?
Oh, yeah, hello.
Hey, listen,
you run after him, don't you?
I don't.
You treat him like a hero, but when he's not there, you don't treat him like a hero.
Hey, Grant, that's a quite... Don't get on your... What is it? Sponge box? Side box? Okay. Listen, how about we get into the mood of today being... What are you doing?
Just okay. Looking up your nostril.
Oh, get out of it. All right?
So that's now, where the car keys went.
Listen, Agro, we might get things started off this morning. And Laurie, hit the music. Laurie's on again today. Louder, please. We can't hear it on the floor. Heaps louder. Sing, Agro. Sing the song.
You sing. Go.
I don't know. Excuse me.
You sing.
Agro, you know what I'm going to have to do?
You sing.
I'm going to have to do
this. Oh, no, not smelling out. Oh.
I'm going to have to do this.
Oh, no, not stereo smell. Oh, no.
All right? Oh, I shouldn't do that.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Snappy Tom.
What do you mean, Snappy Tom?
Birkdale, Grubdale, any sort of Dale High.
Oh, I tell you.
Pretty good lookers, eh?
Adrian from Agro's Casting Connection here. You know, a lot of people say to me, Adrian, where do you get your chicks from? How come you're so successful? And it's really very important to be very successful with chicks. You know, there's lots of different ways you can pick them up, you know. If you want some advice, get a load of this. Sometimes, you know, if you're really, really direct, you know, and you're not embarrassed at all, you can use the direct approach. This is very, very good for picking up chicks really quickly. Like, I'll show you if you like. Come on, let's go and find someone really good looking. Like, come on, over here. Quick, over here. Watch this. Hello, I'm Adrian from Agro's Carlton Connection. Would you like to come up to my apartment and see my Michael Hutchins memorabilia?
No, thanks.
I've got an earring and a sweatband you once threw off the stage. You don't want to see it?
No,
come on, be in it.
No?
No? No? Oh, no. All right. Thanks. Sometimes the direct approach doesn't always work. Then you can try the subtle approach. Be really subtle. Ooh, a couple of them, come on.
Excuse me.
Hello.
Excuse me, I'm Adrian from Agro's Carlton Connection. Would you like to see my Aerosmith tattoos?
Oh yeah, where are they?
It's not really a tat, I did it with poster paints. Problem is every time I sit down it rubs off. Would you like to see it?
Yes.
Oh no.
Depends where it is.
Oh yes, alright, no. Okay, thanks.
Thank you. Yeah.
Sometimes I can actually say yes, and you can really get upset. I'm Adrian from Agro's Castle Connection.
He's a worry too, Adrian.
Oh, he said he had an Aerosmith tattoo and every time he sat down it rubbed off.
I get it. No, I don't. Oh well, never mind. Let's have a look at the Flintstones.
Tattoo.
She brings up stuff.
She does too, and she's very good at what she does.
Yeah?
She should try and actually make an agro out of clay. What do you think?
Well, I don't know. It could be confection.
No. Excuse me.
Or she could try and make a kookaburra.
A kookaburra. Remember last week?
Oh, aren't they a majestic bird?
That's well said they are. And this is a very, very special type of kookaburra called a blue-winged kookaburra. Now, they're not as common as the laughing kookaburras that you and I know.
Does this one laugh?
It sort of...
Because, I mean, they are a member of the kingfisher family, are they not?
They are.
Thank you. Hey, don't get unintelligent after 10 years of wombat. I didn't go to the party, but I still remembered all the stuff.
Yeah, that's enough. It was a very good show. Laughing kookaburras are the ones that are quite common, but this one's the blue-winged kookaburra, a bit different. And
do they laugh?
Well, they know. They don't make... Oh, thank you very much.
Sorry.
Hey, girl, you know not to do that.
Well, my nose starts to run when I got to the high laugh.
Oh, you nearly laughed your head right off then. All I can
when
see
I hit the ozone layer.
And your jaws inside. Yuck, what a sight.
So where do you find these ones?
Look, these ones are found right across the top of Australia, right around Darwin, Perth. They've got them up there, but not around the bottom states of Victoria.
And how come you got him? Where's he from?
Well, sometimes they fly in through Brisbane. Like, they're not common here, but now and again.
Oh, yeah? What on? Yeah. Compass?
No, they use their wings.
Do they? But they don't have landing rights. Do they give a 3-for-1 deal?
No, they don't have that. They don't need it. They're flying.
Like if
through.
You fly a kookaburra to Melbourne, do you get 3 return tickets free on kookaburra?
No, you don't.
Yeah. Do they have a frequent flyer club? But they don't. Do they?
No, they don't.
Do they have a kookaburra frequent flyer club? But they don't. Do they?
Nobody's actually thought of that. Don't even think.
But anyone do that? Hey, imagine kookaburra airlines.
What
and
a
next,
way to
we
go.
We could do stoves and stuff.
How do you mean stoves?
You know, kookaburra stoves.
Ah, you're showing your age now. I haven't been around for a long, long time.
I are 10, 11, nearly 12. But I'm not having a special this year. We're going to rerun the 10 one and 10 pretend I'm 12.
Yes.
And do special computer drawing.
Or look, that's enough. But let's have a look at our cooker, all right? Because he's a very special
cooker. Okay, and they're found all the way around the north?
North of Australia, right. So Darwin, Perth people, they have them up there. Cairns people know them very well. And the nice thing about kookaburras, this time of year we're looking at spring, so they're out and about breeding. Nice thing about kookaburras.
That is the nice thing about spring, isn't it?
It is. Everything's out there breeding. Birds and bees are doing their thing.
The birds and the bees. Let me tell you about the birds and the bees and the flowers.
I knew he was about to sing. Let's have a look at the Flintstones and I'll see if I can shut Agro up. That is enough. Please, you've got such a laugh.
Yes.
can't guess what I am? Yes, I'm an Iron Man. Because this is the wonderful great new Donut King Schweppes Iron Man competition, where you have a chance to go to the Iron Man event of your choice. Now, it could be North Bondi in November, it could be Manly in December, could be Portsea in January next year, or it could be Coolum in sunny Queensland in February. You and a family member get flown from wherever you are in Australia to the event of your choice with East West Airlines, and we'll put you up for 5 nights. That's a wonderful prize, and all you have to do to enter this wonderful competition is write your name, age and address on the back of an envelope and send it in to the Donut King Schweppes Iron Man Competition, GPO Box 787, Brisbane, Queensland 4001. So why don't you win it, and you can be an Iron Man, so, ooh, like boys.
Yes, you could be an Iron Man. How's that?
You could. Don't forget to do the pleats and don't do tram tracks.
What? What did you say then?
Doesn't matter.
Oh, you're going silly today. You really are.
Oh, silly?
You are going
silly. You're going silly today.
Oh, no, actually.
Jackie McDonald does that.
No, she does.
You're going silly today. Here's Australia's funniest video show. Suffering succotash. You notice that?
I would be very careful if I was you.
They're not going to sue me. I'm not even real.
Well, what about me?
You're in big trouble.
Oh, thanks. Let's have a look at the...
Suffering. No milk for 2 weeks. I'll starve.
Things don't.
It's fun.
It's time for pottery with Stephanie. And she's from the Queensland Potters Association. Are you?
Yes, I am. I'm even the president.
The grand poobah, the top of the heap, the numero uno, the big cheese. Yeah, we don't muck around on Cartoon Connection. Okay, what do you got for me today, Steph?
Well, I've got...
Before you tell me, can I ask you another question? Sure. Have you got a new baby?
Yes.
What's your new baby?
He's Jeremy.
Jeremy?
Yeah.
How old? I saw him over there in the cradle.
Yeah, he's 12 weeks old.
And you brought him up to Cartoon Connection?
Well, he has to start out right, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. Yeah, we might as well teach him how to do stuff with clay. Okay, Jeremy, we'll pay attention to this. All right.
Well, this is puppets. This is one of the kids have made in the class. It's an elephant puppet.
Puppets?
Yeah.
That one looks like Mr. Squiggle gone wrong. That looks like
well.
Mr. Squiggle when the bus stopped all of a sudden.
Well, five-year-olds have their own interpretation, don't they? So these are little kids making them.
Yeah, oh, I see. Yeah, because I'm a big 11-year-old.
Yeah, well, you'd make something completely different.
I probably would, yeah. Yeah, because I can't use my arms.
Well, you start off with a nice sort of white ball, and I've made a finished one here.
You mean that comes from what's in your hand?
That's right. It's nice and soft and squishy, and you can just put your thumb up the middle of it.
Yeah.
And that's the start.
Oh, I see. That's how you start.
And then you use the other coloured clay.
Yeah.
Because you can get clay in all sorts of different colours.
Where do you get that from?
Well, first of all, it comes out of the ground. So if you're digging a swimming pool or something, you probably have some around.
Oh, yeah.
Brisbane's built on clay and lots of other cities have big clay deposits in them.
Oh, right.
But you can buy it from any supplier, craft suppliers.
In different colours?
Different colours. You get brown, sort of red... white, all sorts of things.
You seem so relaxed, Stephanie. This must be good for you.
Well, clay is, you know, some people think of it as therapy.
Therapy. I knew a man once who had worry beads.
Yeah, well, you can make your own worry beads out of clay if you want.
And also he had a piece of plasticine he used to squish in his hand all the time, and when his voice used to get louder, he used to squish faster. And then one time I was at a meeting with him and he stood right up in the meeting and threw his plasticine at the wall.
Well, that could explain why potters are involved with clay, because you can do that too.
Oh, right. Mm. So what are you making?
Well, I'm making just a couple of eyes and some big long eyelashes for the beginning of a new clown.
Oh, that looks like Crikey, that other one down there. Have you seen Crikey the clown?
Yes.
He's a bit of a shocker, isn't he? He's a bit loud.
Yeah, I thought his hat looked like his.
Yeah, 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 and also the lips. I think you've got those stretch marks on the lips pretty well there.
Thanks.
That's Crikey, yeah.
But you can fire these in a kiln. Most of the local potters associations in different states can fire them for you. Or when they're really dry, you can paint them with ordinary paints and then coat them with varnish and they'll last for years.
Well, you are so relaxed, Stephanie. I might try this. This is something I should try. And if you'd like to try, just give your potters association in the state you're in a call and they'll all be just as relaxed as Stephanie and they'll help you right out. Where are we off to? We're going to a commercial break and then we're coming back.
Okay.
Okay. Gotta need it, haven't I?
Yep.
Girls, come over here quick. Boys and girls, today, Quirky the Clown is going to be a karaoke clown. I've got my music, you know what karaoke is, boys and girls, where people sing along with the music. It's a riot, boys and girls, because most people can't sing. Most people are tone deaf. And it's a real hoot when you get them to sing songs, and they listen, oh, it's marvellous, boys and girls. That's why I'm hiding here, waiting to find someone as they walk past to be my karaoke clown victim of the day. Morning. Yes. It's morning. Lady has corrected Crikey the Clown, boys and girls. It is morning. I'm a karaoke clown today.
I do that at home.
What do you do at home?
Sing.
I've got a lovely song and I wonder if you'd come along and do some karaoke with me.
No.
Come on, let me in it.
No.
All the little boys and girls out there want to see you. You watch Cartoon Connection, don't you? You watch Agro? You're a fan of Agro?
I come from Mount Isa.
Well, you can still watch Cartoon Connection from Mount Isa.
I'm coming to Mount Isa.
We'll arrange something.
Okay.
Come down here. Come on. Just bring your shopping. My sister-in-law lives in Mount Isa. Yeah. This is going to be absolutely marvellous. There's the words, darling. I'll help you sing. I'll come over here and stand over here. This is marvellous. Isn't it wonderful? I bet you never thought today you'd be shopping and you'd end up singing New York, New York in the middle of the mall in front of hundreds of people.
You're right.
All right. Now, I want you to do a little bit of a Frank Sinatra for me, boys. What's your name, darling?
Carmel.
Yes. All right, Carmel. Here we go. This is going to be absolutely marvellous, Carmel. Now, you got to wait. I'll point you in, all right?
Yeah.
This is the introduction.
I know.
Done this before. All right, ready? Nice and loud, Carmel. Start spreading the news.
I'm leaving today.
Tone deaf, what I tell you. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. Point to your shoes. These vagabonds, they are vagabond shoes. Have a go at them. Are longing to stride. You've got to do a bit of a step over, a Frank Sinatra. Around this way. Around the heart of it. New York, New York. Okay, here we go. Hit the big note, boys and girls. I want to wake up. Don't get ahead of the music, you stupid woman. To sleep. To find I'm king of the hill. Top of the heap. Oh, sorry, yes, she's right. I'm melting away. Bit of a soft shuffle, come on. A brand new start of it. In old New York. You look like Frank Sinatra, darling. If I can make it there, I'll make it anywhere. It's the big one. It's up to you. Last note. Come on, louder. Hold that note. Hold it. Hold it. Marvellous! Absolutely superb!
Can I go now?
You can go, darling. I've embarrassed you enough.
Yes.
Absolutely marvellous. Don't ever go on Broadway, will you, sweetheart? Well, they can't sing, see, darling, boys and girls.
Was it calm or good? She got in the swing of it and everything.
She did too. She looks like she was having a bit of...
Those vagabond shoes.
That's a good song actually, very old song. So maybe all the kids' mums and dads might have a few old Frank Sinatra records.
My butcher sings that.
Does he?
Eat pork. Bam, bam, bam.
Eat beef. You could do heaps of that, couldn't you?
Beef? I think you've just ruined it.
Oh, sorry.
You can take it anywhere. Yeah, sirloin of beef, da-da-da-da. Eat pork.
Chicken fillets. Sing something about chicken fillets now.
No, what about, let's frisket for some brisket.
Yeah, no. That's where this comes in. That's where we have...
Anything, let's go to anything, I don't care. Just roll anything.
You know, one of the most important things when you're in the bush is looking your best.
and I'm looking my best today with my pretty face vanity kit. Yes, got a nice mirror and some makeup in here, and you can just pop on a bit of lipstick or a bit of rouge if you're out in the sun. This is part of a wonderful new prize here on Cartoon Connection. Actually, I'll show you another thing with a makeup case. If you get lost in the bush, you can send for help like this. Semaphore with a mirror that says, send me a cappuccino, no sugar. Isn't that marvellous? I'll show you something else too. Look, a musical box. Oh, isn't that lovely? Can't you see yourself sitting under a tree with this playing? This is actually part of a wonderful prize I did before on Cartoon Connection. We've got a Kids Biz Super Surprise Pack. Have a look at this. They've got some wonderful things to give away. We've got a Head Start Talking School, a Rumbler Strobe, a Motor Muncher. Oh, I showed you the pretty face vanity case. We've got a large musical jewelry box, which I also showed you. We've got a Susie Snapshot, Nicole's House, a Head Start Typewriter. What a wonderful prize. If you'd like to win some of these prizes, we've got two major packs to give away. Two boxes chock-a-block full of wonderful Kids Biz products. Right into the Kids Biz Super Surprise Prize. Care of Cartoon Connection, GPO Box 787, Brisbane, Queensland. Excuse me, I've just got to put a bit of eyeliner on.
Riveting, isn't it? Really? What do you think about riveting telly, isn't it?
Riveting. Absolutely riveting.
All right, it's time now for the new Yogi Bear Show. Where's his name gone? It's from Sam King.
Sam King.
Sam King.
I know his brother Joe.
Joe King. From Barowa or Barowa Heights in New South Wales. And what has he sent us in his big post pack? Oh, can you see anything else in there? No? Oh, Agro.
Hang on, hold still. No.
No. Okay. All right. Let's have a look at this.
Must be a project.
Oh, wow. Isn't this terrific? Yeah, Agro, that's the way. Hold that bit down there.
Oh, look,
we'll show
this.
Bits at a time.
We're talking severe closeness to character.
Isn't that terrific? All the Agro superheroes and everything. All right, here we go. There's a letter here. Quickly open this one up. Da-da-da. You tired today, are you?
A little bit.
Are you? Oh, you get that on Mondays, though, don't you? Everyone gets a bit tired. I had a lovely weekend. Dear Agro, I think you
did
are
you
very
clear bush?
Pardon?
Did you clear some bush?
I did too. Got out there with me boots on and did, got out and dug holes and dug a dam and I didn't dig the dam. A tractor did. My mum says that you're too cheeky, but I like it when you pick on Ann-Maree and I think you are a cool dude. Mum says Ann-Maree deserves a medal or a pay rise. Did you hear that? Les, did you hear
that? Okay, you're up to $50 a week.
To put up with all the Agro he's written here. I want to come and see the Super Sunday Show if I ever get to sunny Queensland. From Sam King and his 7.5. Sam, thank you so much.
Sam, thank you so much.
We've got a great pack that we're going to send you.
It'll look something like this, a selection of this stuff.
Yeah, okay.
Do they get all of this stuff or just a selection?
A selection. We've got the Plaster Funhouse thing there.
You get a plaster toad, a donut, some shoelaces. Yeah, we're talking big stuff here.
Big time.
Some non-skid socks. We've really gone out of our way.
Big budget, okay. So there you go. And don't forget the Donut King vouchers. So thank you very much for that, Sam. That's fantastic. Agro, maybe we can pin this up.
Yeah, let's pin it up somewhere.
All right, well, we'll put it up over there on our big map of Australia.
Perhaps you could pin it up at your place.
That's a big...
In the kitchen.
I've already got a dartboard.
Well, what about... Oh, I bet I know whose photo's on it too.
No.
You want me to go further?
No, thank you.
Do you?
No.
I know. I know.
Excuse me.
Ow, don't stand on the man. I bet I know who's ow. I bet I know whose photo's on it.
No, Agro, I'm not like that, but I'm a champion at darts. I'm a mean dart
player. Yeah, I know you are.
I am.
Yeah. Very, you keep chucking them, don't you?
Very accurate, I am.
Yeah.
Agro, stop it. That's enough. All right? I won't hit you with
that. No, don't, because everyone writes in.
Yes. All right. I won't give you a stand. But, yeah, no, I'll put that up. Where would you like me to put that up?
Next to your dartboard with a photo of...
Who? I don't have photos on my dartboard. I know somebody who
does. Were you yelling at in the dressing room about 2 weeks ago?
Oh, some insignificant person.
Excuse me. Bye now.
It's all right. teeth, it's all right.
I'm not coming out.
Let's have a look at the new Yogi Bear show. I love this tambourine, I think it's great.
Take it home.
No, it's good, it makes a lot of noise. It's annoying though, a little bit, but I'd hate a child to be walking around the house all day going, but I think it's great.
Okay, you hit it, I'll sing.
Okay.
Hey, Mr. Tambourine Man, sing a song for me.
You're going to speed up now when I speed up, okay? So.
Go. Hey, Mr. Tambourine Man, sing a song for me.
Oh.
What's wrong with you? Okay, play Stairway to Heaven. Go on.
No, I don't know how it goes.
Play Smoke on the Water.
Okay. Yeah. There. That's it.
Jetson.
To be cheerful. Reason to be cheerful. Mums and daughters both agree they love the look of hickory. Something right for every age and savings on the entire range. Reasons to be cheerful as a buyer.
Get over it. 4 D's and an...
Welcome back. It's time for the vibes.
It is too. Another day down. Another day, another 50 cents.
Exactly. Well, it is after the tax.
Oh, come on, scumbags. Get up and earn some tax.
No, I think the other one's a bit more politer than that now.
Which one?
The other one that's in charge now.
Yeah.
Oh, are you tired?
I am a bit. Have I still got to go to school?
Yeah, today.
Or is it holidays?
No, today.
Oh, the writing's coming up.
Well, the writing is, today you do have to go to school, but listen, I'll tell you what, we might be able to pick you up early this afternoon and you can come home early.
How will I get home early?
Well, I'll come pick you up.
Yeah, but how do I get home early, though?
Well, I'll ring the headmaster, okay?
But remember what he said to you at the fete?
Oh, I know Lex from Rockley State School, I know him. He's pretty cool, Agro, don't worry about him. He'll be fine. Have a good day, everybody. Bye-bye.
What am I doing over here?
Yeah! Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Cartoon Connection. What's that off?
You know?
What?
A chicka chicka chi, a chicka chicka cha.
A chicka chicka chi, a chicka chicka cha. No, I don't know. Oh, you know who's up there playing that music?
Who?
Laurie.
You know his mother named him after a truck?
Yeah?
Yeah.
True?
Yeah.
Oh, what, Mac? Hey? Never mind. Yeah, Agro, you can play with this, but you've got to have the little thing to hang it up with. Because it won't work.
No, your little piece of ribbon like we have at state school.
Yeah, or rubber band. A rubber band is just as good. This is a friend of mine's got one of these for the cows, and they get out the back, and we go, come on, come on. And all the little cows go, oh, dinner time, and they race up the hill. They do.
Thank you for sharing that with me.
It's all right. They're black and white cows.
Big ones. Rommel cows.
Rommel cows. Big Rommel cows.
Illawarra Shorthorn.
Yeah. Are they? Is that what they call them?
I don't know.
It's a pinch and a punch for the first day of the month, Agro.
What day
is it?
It's
Tuesday the 1st of October.
Is it?
It is nearly Christmas time. Can you believe that?
October, November, December. How do you get that disappointingly Christmas time?
Oh, well, it's nearly Christmas
time. It's only 12
time.
Weeks.
Yeah, well, that's nearly Christmas time. Can you believe it?
Oh, I wonder what I'm getting at Christmas.
What would you like? You'll have to write a big letter to Santa.
A new show?
A new show.